I welcome class 5 students for this computer subject. This is class 5 and chapter name of this computer subject is evolution of computer. Learning in this chapter is history of computers, early calculating devices, generation of computers and characteristics and limitations of computer. In this session we will discuss about these four points. Students, please follow the moving mouse cursor. I am painting mouse cursor in color. Now every aspect of our life in this present era has been influenced by most of the advanced machine. Now these advanced machines are known as computers. Initially, computers were used by scientists, but nowadays, general people, general businessmen and students use computer. You all have computers in your home and we have computers in our school also. Computer have now been basic necessity. It is required by every student, every bank, hospital, media, newspaper, television, industry, rocket space technology, railway, airport. Now, the term computer is derived from the word compute, which means to calculate. But modern calculation is not limited for computer because computers are very, very fast. A computer is a versatile device that can handle different applications at same time. It means you can type something, you can listen to music, you can chat, you can do everything with a computer. Now, how a computer came into existence? It means the computer we see today is not the computer it was in early days. So, let us go to check the history of computer. The need to keep track of number led to the invention of different type of calculating device that were machines, starting from Chinese abacus to the modern computers. So let us check one by one. Early calculating devices. First one was abacus. It was a mechanical device for calculation which was developed in China. That was 3000 BC. It was made up of wooden frame with rods. Students, please see the figure. This is abacus. Students in early classes still uses abacus. The frame was divided into two parts, heaven and earth. Upper side was heaven, lower side was earth. Each rod has two beads, and each rod in earth has 5 beads. You can see heaven has 2 beads and earth has 5 beads. It was used for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Second machine in the discussion was actually Pascal's calculator. Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, invented an adding machine called Pascal machine, Pascal calculator or Pascaline. At the age of 19, students look at this figure. This is actually Pascal machine or Pascaline. Now, it uses gear. The gear is similar to what we use in our automobile. It uses gear, dials and wheels. Numbers were displayed by rotating the wheel and it was capable of doing addition and subtraction. The gear principle was further employed in many mechanical calculator and modern taximeter is perfect example of a mechanical calculator. In our home, the older electric meter uses gear. Third one was Leibniz calculator. Leibniz was a famous German mathematician. In 1671, ही इन्वेंटेड लाइबनीज कैलकुलेटर विच वॉज अ मैकेनिकल डिवाइस. अपार्ट फ्रॉम परफॉर्मिंग एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन, लाइबनीज कैलकुलेटर कैन डू मल्टीप्लीकेशन, डिवीजन एंड स्क्वायर रूट. लुक एट दिस फिगर, दिस फिगर इज लाइबनीज कैलकुलेटर. नेक्स्ट वन इन्वेंशन वॉज बाई चार्ल्स बैबेज. चार्ल्स बैबेज वॉज ए ब्रिटिश इंग्लिश मैथमेटिशियन ग्रेट ब्रिटेन एंड ही इज कंसिडर्ड एज फादर ऑफ कंप्यूटर. स्टूडेंट्स रिमेंबर, फादर ऑफ कंप्यूटर इज चार्ल्स बैबेज. ही इन्वेंटेड अ वर्किंग मॉडल ऑफ अ मैकेनिकल कंप्यूटर कॉल्ड डिफरेंस इंजिन इन 1822 एंड 11 ईयर आफ्टर इन 1833 ही इन्वेंटेड एनालिटिकल इंजिन. द एनालिटिकल इंजिन हैज फाइव पार्ट्स. स्टूडेंट्स रिमेंबर द पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट वॉज इनपुट, आउटपुट, स्टोर, मिल एंड कंट्रोल. दीज यूनिट्स वर्क लाइक ए मॉडर्न कंप्यूटर. ऑल द कंप्यूटर्स विच आर यूज इन हाउस डे यूजेस दीज फाइव यूनिट्स मोर और लेस सिमिलर. स्टोर वॉज यूज फॉर स्टोरिंग द डेटा एंड मिल वॉज यूज फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग यूनिट. कंट्रोल सिस्टम वॉज यूज फॉर सुपरवाइजिंग ऑल द यूनिट्स. नेक्स्ट वन इन आवर डिस्कशन इज एक्चुअली बूलियन लॉजिक. जॉर्ज बूल वॉज एन इंग्लिश ब्रिटिश मैथमेटिशियन. ही रियलाइज दैट कॉम्प्लेक्स मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम्स कुड बी सॉल्व बाई डिवाइडिंग देम इन टू स्मॉलर पार्ट्स एंड दीज क्वेश्चन हैव पॉजिटिव और निगेटिव एंसर. इट मीन्स एंसर विल बी आइदर येस और नो. ही लिंक्ड देम विथ बाइनरी नंबर एंड रिप्रेजेंटेड द पॉजिटिव बाई वन, निगेटिव बाई जीरो. दिस इज कॉल्ड बुलियन लॉजिक एंड वी यूज बुलियन लॉजिक टूडे ऑल्सो. वन मीन्स पॉजिटिव, इट मीन्स येस एंड जीरो मीन्स नो. नेक्स्ट मशीन वॉज ए टेबुलेटिंग मशीन. इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाई अमेरिकन स्टैटिस्टिशियन नेम्ड हरमन हॉलरिथ. इट वॉज कैपेबल ऑफ रीडिंग डेटा, प्रोसेसिंग एंड गिव आउट द डिजायर्ड आउटपुट. दिस इज टेबुलेटिंग मशीन, इट वॉज ए बिग मशीन. द इनपुट वॉज गिवेन थ्रू पंच कार्ड. पंच कार्ड हैव होल्स ऑल्सो. पंच कार्ड वेयर यूज टू रिकॉर्ड स्टोर डेटा और इंफॉर्मेशन. नेक्स्ट मशीन वॉज कॉल्ड मार्क वन. यू कैन सी दिस इज मार्क वन, इट वॉज ऑल्सो ए बिग मशीन. इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाई हॉवर्ड एकिंग. ही वॉज प्राइमरी इंजीनियर इन आई बी एम. आई बी एम इज इन अमेरिका. फुल फॉर्म ऑफ आई बी एम इज इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस मशीन. मार्क वन वॉज डेवलप्ड इन 1944 एंड इट वॉज एन ऑटोमेटिक मशीन विच रन्स ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक. नेक्स्ट मशीन वॉज कॉल्ड ENIAC. फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ENIAC इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेटर एंड कंप्यूटर एंड इट वॉज फर्स्ट जनरल पर्पस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिजिटल कंप्यूटर. इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय मॉकले एंड एकार्ट इन 1946. इट कंसिडर्स द कंपोजिशन ऑफ 18,000 वैक्यूम ट्यूब्स एंड वॉज 100,000 टाइम्स फास्टर देन मार्क वन एंड इट कैन एड टू लार्ज नंबर इन 200 माइक्रो सेकेंड्स. द एडवांस वर्सन ऑफ ENIAC वॉज ADSAC. फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ADSAC वॉज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिले स्टोरेज ऑटोमेटिक कैलकुलेटर एंड इट वॉज डिजाइंड बाई प्रोफेसर विल्किस एट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कैम्ब्रिज इन 1949. दिस कंप्यूटर वॉज कैपेबल टू रन ग्राफिकल कंप्यूटर गेम्स. स्टूडेंट्स यू प्ले गेम्स. फर्स्ट गेम मशीन वॉज ADSAC एंड द फर्स्ट नेम ऑफ द गेम वॉज बेबी. बेबी वॉज द नेम ऑफ फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर गेम. नेक्स्ट मशीन कॉल्ड ADVAC. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिस्क्रीट वेरिएबल ऑटोमेटिक कंप्यूटर. इट वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय जॉन वॉन न्यूमैन. जॉन वॉन न्यूमैन फिगर इज गिवन हियर एंड इट वॉज स्टार्ट ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर इंडस्ट्री. Softwares were written in binary codes. Binary codes are 1 and 0. It was John von Neumann who started the practice of storing data and instructions in binary codes. Binary codes means 1 and 0. Later year, Neumann collaborated with Eckhart and Macaulay in consulting the ADVAC machine. ADVAC concept of storing different program on punch card led to the development of more advanced computer. The first advanced computer was called UNIVAC 1. Full form of UNIVAC is Universal Automatic Computer 1. It was first commercially available computer which was sold in market. This machine was developed by Eckhart and Macaulay in 1951. It was first computer to handle both numeric and text data. It was first computer that uses magnetic tape. Students, you have seen the magnetic tape in earlier tape recorder machine or VCR machine. Now students, we will see the generation of computer. There are many generations of computer and we are now checking the fourth and fifth generation of computer. So let us start with our first generation of computer, which was during 1940 to 1956. The first generation of computer uses vacuum tubes and magnetic tapes. These computers relied on machine language and they were able to solve one problem at any time. Input was given on punch card and paper tapes. Output was displayed on printout. The computers were slow, very very costly and very large in size. They consume a lot of electric power. Second generation computer started in 1956 to 1963 and they used a small transistor in place of vacuum tubes, and since they were using transistors, they consume less electric. They relied on magnetic tapes, but they were not using machine language, they were using assembly language. Then what is the difference between first generation and second generation? In second generation computer, less electric was utilized. They used assembly language and they used transistors. Punch card and paper tapes were used as input device and output was printed. They were faster, cheaper, smaller and more efficient than the first generation computers. Third generation of computers arrived in 1964 to 1971 and they were now using integrated circuits. They were not using vacuum tubes or transistor. They used IC. So they were using very very less electric. Magnetic disk was used for storage. Pascal and RPG language came into existence. Pascal was earliest language. The computer were small in size and their storage capacity was increased. And during this time, keyboard was introduced. So keyboard was introduced during third generation of computer. IBM System 360 and Apple I, along with Altair system, was developed. The fourth generation of computer arrived in 1972. Students, we are using the fourth generation now and they used VLSI circuit. VLSI circuit is very large scale integrated circuits. They are called microprocessor chips. Today, Pentium chips, Intel chips, AMD chips are used. You have known Core 2 Duo, Core i3, Core i5, Core i7. High capacity magnetic disks are used to store data. We are saying them hard disk. Input is done through mouse, scanner or keyboard. Monitor and printer were new devices introduced during this time, and many computers can be linked together to form a network. This is the basic of internet. The use of microprocessor result in decreased size, increased efficiency. The computers were very, very small, so they were portable and cheapest. Fourth generation computer was Macintosh, IBM PC. Now students, we will see fifth generation of computer, which are evolving nowadays. They uses artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is the way of thinking of computer, just the way we think. It means machine can also think like human think. These computers are still in development, and it will take a few more years to get fifth generation of computers. So computer is a very good machine and we need them. So what are the good properties of computer? Let us see them. The first good property of computer is speed. It means speed is the time taken by a computer to complete a job. A computer works very faster and can do large number of calculations quickly as compared to human beings. And computers are evolving very, very faster. Second good point in computer is accuracy. Accuracy means degree of perfection. It means how correct computer can do a work. Computer do not do or commit errors. They are capable of handling complex instructions. And if the data or your coding is wrong, then it may produce different result. If your data is okay and your coding is okay, computer will always give you correct result. Third good thing is reliability. Reliability means quality of a computer output. Now, in case of any failure in computer system, there is a provision for immediate backup. So, computers are very, very reliable also. Fourth point is versatility. It means computer can perform many tasks at same time. It means it can do all types of work like education, science and technology, business, finance, everything. Next good point is storage. Storage is the capacity of computer to store data. A computer can store large amount of data which can be used anytime. We can see a storage device like CD, DVD disk, pen drive, chips, hard disk. They all are storage device, and maximum amount of data can be stored with this device. Next good point is diligence. Computer are not respondent to human factor. It means fatigue, tiredness or boredom. It can work for long hours without taking rest, but human or animal have to take rest. Last good point of computer is multitasking. It means computer can do many tasks at same times. But computer have some limitations also, like computer is not capable to think. Computer has no intelligence. It means computer can do only thing which we provide, and computer also depend on electric power. So students, this was the first chapter. Please go through the video again and again. You can see we have completed this chapter, and students, I am also providing the PDF version and students, you have to replay the video as many times as you can. You can see I am also providing you the answers here. All the answers are provided here, you can see. So write in your book, write in your notebook, you can see all the answer I have written for you. So please revise the video as many times as you can, and we will start next session, next chapter. Till then, bye bye.